there are kind of two different types of mugshots that go out there in the world. There's the Tiger Woods, Bill Cosby, pathetic figure mugshot. And then there's the mugshots that you see of people like Frank Sinatra when he was young, or Janis Joplin. And these mugshots, which include people like MLK, these project a different image, not sad and pathetic, but an image of defiance. And I think that what you're seeing right there is defiance. And that's the exact message that Trump wants to convey.
Oh yeah, there's, you know, there's two types of mugshots. There's the really hot mugshots, and then there's the not hot mugshots. And then there's MLK, which if we can't miss an opportunity to make sure we compare Donald Trump to Martin Luther King Jr. Which is the only thing is that they both have a J somewhere in their names. But obviously this is all fallout from last week's booking in Fulton County of prisoner P01135809, AKA the 45th president of the United States, Donald Trump. And in case you were wondering, you have the mugshot again. There he was. And but that wasn't all that Fox News had to offer. They weren't just saying that he was like MLK. Jesse Waters took it a little bit farther. Take a look.
Judge, and I say this with a unblemished record of heterosexuality. He looks good. And he looks hard. And why would you think that you wouldn't practice the shot? Is that a surprise? Of course you practice the mug shot. You only don't practice if you're drunk.
He looks good, and I have an unblemished record of heterosexuality. Oh gosh, so much cringe, Senator. The most cringe, but there they are. I mean, honestly, he looks hard. It feels like Jesse Waters might be hard. I'm sorry, people, I apologize. But there they are, they're just fawning over him. What can they do? He looks great, he's incredible. We love him, this is not a sad mugshot, this is a good mugshot. Your thoughts?
Only in an alternative universe would you find people glorifying mugshots. Now, if that was a mugshot of President Barack, Hussein, Obama, do you think they would be glorifying the mugshot? Absolutely not. And the only reason why they brought up Dr. Martin Luther King Jr., let me remind our viewers that at the time that the Reverend Dr. Martin Luther King Jr. was alive, he was vilified by both white people and black people. A total blemish on the black community. I'm put that in the parking lot. He was not beloved in the way that people think that he was at the time, because at the time he was shaking up the system. So we got two different types of mugshots here. We got a mugshot of a man who stood up for justice and for a beloved community and for the right to vote, et cetera, et cetera, et cetera, unions, that kind of thing. The first march on Washington, as we celebrate the 60th or remember the 60th anniversary on the march on Washington for jobs and freedom. Let's underline, bolded, underscored, exclamation point, jobs and freedom, where the Reverend Dr. Martin Luther King Jr. gave his I Have a Dream speech. Totally different mugshot. And then we got a mugshot of a dude who is so self-absorbed that he wanted his own vice president to throw the election, that they just wanted to overturn a democratically elected opponent of his in now President Joseph R. Biden. Two different type of mugshots. Jessica, these people are out of their ever loving minds. There's no other way to describe
the
clips that we just showed.
Right, and it's so funny that the first commentator, he's like, like Tiger Woods and Bill Cosby, not to like, I mean, Bill Cosby, I do not condone at all, but like, okay, two black men. And then Janis Joplin and Sinatra happened to be white. And then MLK Jr., who has been so whitewashed by the likes of Fox News that he's honorary white in their minds, right? It's just like, oh, the one black guy. It's like, yeah, MLK Jr. and Clarence Thomas. It's like, there, yeah, yay, they're fine. It's just so, so racially not even coded, it's just right there.
Check out the Damage Report podcast each day, wherever you get your podcasts, whether Pocket Casts or Stitcher or iTunes. You can join me as I give you the news and stories you want, with a range of co-hosts and interview guests jumping in on the fun each day. Again, that's the Damage Report, wherever you get your podcasts. And if you get them at iTunes, don't forget to rate and review. Sometimes I'll read them live on the show.